Now your WAPT.com Storm Shield 16 weather.
Awful August heat. It is brutal, but you know what? I'll show you some things where it is worse off to our west. Hot, high pressure, the dominance of hot air in the atmosphere, giving us practically no afternoon and evening thunderstorms down along the coast, some coming out of the Ozark Mountains. That is it. There's that center of the high pressure system in this entire area this afternoon has gotten to 105 or higher. Some cases it's the hottest temperature ever recorded with the heat wave extending all the way along the Gulf Coast. Little Rock had a high of 114 this afternoon, hottest ever recorded. 111 late this afternoon, back through the Arklatex, 114, 110, 107. Jackson struggling to get to 99, some puffy clouds today. Tupelo, 105, Greenville, 106. Now you do factor in the humidity and some of the highest real feel numbers I've ever seen. Little Rock down to Monroe feeling close to 120 degrees this afternoon. While here in the central Mississippi area, our real feel has exceeded 100 since about 10 o'clock in the morning and has persisted and will persist through a little bit later on tonight. Closer to home, Vicksburg is at 100, Greenville is at 100, up to Oxford and Columbus, all up over 100 degrees, closer to that hot dome of air. Here are our real feel numbers, and there you see what I'm talking about. Just about everybody exceeding 105. Down along the coast, bit of a sea breeze, so a little bit of a reprieve from the oppressive heat. Real feel numbers, look at that. 10 o'clock tomorrow morning will be up over the 100-degree mark, staying there most of the day, getting close to about 110 to 115 through the hottest part of the day. Again, targeting 10 to 8 for the brunt of the heat, but even outside that time range, there's really no relief from the heat. It is just brutal at night as well. So through the end of the week, that big dome of high pressure and hot air remains in control. I am expecting it to shove back to the west as we head towards the end of the weekend, and that could allow a couple afternoon thunderstorms, and we should be able to shave some temperatures, degrees off the highs, maybe getting back down into the upper and maybe eventually middle 90s. Keep your fingers crossed. Emily, down here in the Caribbean, very disorganized, and we're still expecting that curve, but there certainly is certainly concern for the southeastern United States. We'll just have to wait and see. Later tonight, tomorrow, will be going over Hispaniola. Should weaken some, we'll just have to wait and see what happens with Emily. Here it is, 103 on Thursday, near 100 through Saturday, and there you see perhaps just a few degrees taken off those highs, but one thing's for sure, the heat wave is going to continue well into next week.